Good morning, everyone. Today, I'm sharing my deepest secret on street photography. Yes, I still have some. Oh, yeah. So if you watched part one on street photography, you know we talked about the settings, the gear, etc. A lot of you have asked me actually to talk about something that's way less technical, and it's really about how do you build confidence when you're shooting in the streets, when you're shooting strangers, how do you interact with people, how do you get those raw emotions. And I thought, let's make a part two on that topic because it's super important in my opinion. It's something I struggle with even nowadays, but I have a few tricks and hopefully they can help you. But before we dive right into it, I want to say a huge thank you to all of you who've been watching the channel, who left awesome comments. You guys went to Instagram and went totally crazy, and I really enjoyed that. I saw some of your work and I was blown away by you guys. So keep sharing your Instagram, keep sharing what you're creating. I really love it, really inspires me also to create more. So today let's talk about all those things. He didn't want a picture taken, which is totally cool. So now he ran away. First, let's recognize it. It's super difficult. It takes a lot of, I would say, confidence building to actually approach people who are totally random, get to them and ask them if you can take their photo or just take sneaky photos, which personally I don't really like too much doing. Whenever you have the face of the person, I feel like you're taking a bit of their privacy. So I really like to ask those people, hey, can I take a photo of you or not? So in case you're wondering, right now we're in Lombok in Indonesia, and obviously it changes from Tokyo a lot. It's a totally different setting. No one's in a suit here. So it makes up for different style of street photography. Whichever country you're in, whenever you want to interact with people, the first thing that's super important is to actually talk to them, in my opinion. So if you're shooting their face, just talk to them. If you're sniping from long, you don't really need to, but whenever you can, have interaction with them and always learn in their language how to say, can I take a photo of you? Because that's super important. Sometimes they don't speak English and that breaks the barrier also. So here it's something like, Dapatkah saya foto, and that means can I take a photo, basically in very broken Indonesian, but it's easier to remember than the long sentence and people will understand you. I asked the guy, he said no, totally cool, we're gonna find something else to shoot. He said yes, but I don't know how the picture turned out. Whenever you're taking photos of people, if you're asking them to pose slightly, remember, do not let your eye off the camera until you're totally done. What I mean by that is that usually you get raw emotional interaction after the people are done posing. So for example, you ask them to pose, they're gonna feel uncomfortable, just like every freaking one else on this planet. But then suddenly they're gonna release when they think you are done, but that's the moment you wanna get the shot actually. You, most of the time, I don't know if I got it right this time, but it's something I like to think about because that's how even with my normal clients back in Paris, I used to get the best shots with the best emotions in them. Overall, it's not that complicated, but it takes practice. It's basically interact with the people as if they were your friends. So obviously you buy them a beer, you buy them shots, stuff like that whenever you're doing street photography. No, but seriously, just interact with them, just talk to them, maybe show them the picture after, because you would never shoot your friend and not show him the picture. They want to know what it looked like. Maybe they've never seen it before. They've never seen a picture of themselves. That happens in some countries, and that's actually kind of awesome to show them. There are a few other things I want to share with you. I think one's going to be about security, meaning safety for your gear, whatever, and for yourself when you're shooting like that. Another one is also, how do you get the best scenes? This is a perfect example of trying to get a good scene, in the sense that you really want to understand your environment. And we're driving here and I saw this fire over here. It was creating a lot of smoke and I'm like, wow, what if we can get one of those shots, you know, where you have a lot of smoke and you have that guy coming peeking through the smoke, maybe with a buffalo or something, because that's kind of the feeling here with the rice plantations. Hasn't happened, but that's a good example of just take your time, try to get a shot. I think I'm gonna get sunburned if we don't keep moving, so I'm gonna, yeah, that shot's not gonna happen. My god, that is hilarious, guys. I've been waiting for like 15 minutes for something to happen. I tell you, wait for something. The moment I'm like, okay, let's just go, the truck's trying to get, something awesome happens. And these kids are so fun. If you're afraid of adults, maybe just ask the kids if they wanna play with you, if they're okay to take some photos. Usually they are, sometimes they're not, but also be respectful of their privacy. Totally got distracted by the kids in the school. It just looks so awesome, and the kids like playing with the rays of light, everything. Anyway, I'm going geek mode, but I really, really love that light shining through, so I couldn't help it but just stop. The other point I wanted to talk was just simply like security and safety, but really depends where you travel, guys, because if you're in Japan or Tokyo, you have no reason to fear whatsoever that anyone's gonna steal your gear. It's number one safest country in the world, it's amazing. But if you're in other countries or areas where you feel a bit dodgy, just that story, my friend Laszlo, who's shooting right now, got all his stuff robbed, like, when was it, 2 days ago? And they were just behind us with scooters. Anyway, crazy story, you can check on his channel. Really sucks, but he still has the camera at least and the main lens, which is awesome because, yeah, that, I mean, can you imagine losing your stuff? So, how do you prevent stuff like that from happening? How do you prevent simply people from lurking too much at your gear? Especially if you have stupid gear like me, that is huge. So here's my tip. First of all, just try to be discreet. Don't like openly show that you have 100 million lenses in your bag. If you have a small camera and you're really not confident, I highly recommend you to start shooting with point and shoot camera. No one's gonna give a crap about you being around. Use your phone. Stuff like that really helps. First, it's gonna build your confidence when you're walking around because you're not gonna feel like people look at you for your camera. You feel confident to actually go out there and shoot those people, interact with them, talk to them. Remember, that's the key. Otherwise, if you really love expensive gear and you're taking it out, I don't know if you stole my lens, but I call it the zebra lens. So what I started doing is like patching a whole bunch of tape all around the lens to make it look older. I don't know if it really works, but also mainly to hide all the brand, all the information about the lens, what kind of lens it might be. Because people, if they're stealing stuff, usually they know the price of stuff. If they see 2.8 or F4, they're gonna know there's huge difference. So that makes it look kind of weird and almost like an alien, kind of. So they might be weirded out. If you look at the camera also, there's no brand whatsoever on my camera. I always have something stuck on it that's actually hiding the model of the camera so that no one can tell if it's an old one or if it's a new one. And also, I link it below in the description. You can buy like fake scratches, stickers, and I highly recommend you, if you get your hands on them, like they're on Amazon, I link it below, just stick them all over your camera if you're afraid, if you're going in countries where it's not really safe to hang around with your gear. And people will look at you and be like, oh, this guy has like, his camera looks like it's been beaten up. Why would I try to take it? That's my personal take on it. So just be mindful of that. Your gear might be more than what people make in a whole year in some countries. So just pay attention to your surrounding and be mindful, and just don't put it too much in people's face also. Those are my 2 cents, guys. Photography is really about doing your passion, having fun, like getting out there and shooting. Don't worry too much, talk to people, have fun, like think about it as if you wanted to really have fun. I have not always been that confident. There are many times I actually spend like minutes and minutes just walking around the place, not being able to approach a scene or people because I was a bit shy. But then, just like that, I remember, what are you trying to do? What kind of thing are you trying to capture here? And how would you like it to come out? And once I just realized that, I'm like, okay, just own it, go for it, go get your shot. I'm gonna let you go with that. See you guys tomorrow. Wait. I'm traveling all around the world right now with my wife on a world tour. There are a lot more photography video coming up like that. So if you like that, make sure you subscribe and share it with your friends. Sharing is caring. I'm sure someone else wants to hear about like stories of photographer falling in rice plantation, trying to take street photography with no street around and in the field, right? Laszlo. Go say thanks if you like the video. If you don't like it, just go hate on this comment.
Hey, no,
button.
Don't do that. Don't do that.
Kidding.
Hate on this one instead. Then come over.
Anyway,
it was awesome shooting with you.
Big thanks, man.
Anytime,
thank you so
man.
Much.
It was really great.
Absolutely.
Had a great time. Like the video. Subscribe.
To him, obviously.
No, both.
To both, to everyone. And go to Instagram, go everywhere, just spam the word about us. Just kidding, maybe not. I don't know, if we wanna hit 1 million one day, maybe we should. I mean, why not, right?